with the rain, I must smile on my face.
In the world of
fire, fire. You all will pay for this!
Hi, I'm Patty Granville. I'd like to welcome you today to Arts in Action. Joining me on the set is Kim Pageau, who's the marketing director for the Arts Center here. And also, she is very active with the Quilt Club, the Modern Quilt Club of Dallas, and with the GSM Guild. She is their your communications director for everything, and the Downtown Business
Pretty
Group,
much.
Too. You're doing newsletters and brochures, and you're just so talented, Kim, and it's wonderful having you on the staff here at the Arts Center,
Well, thank
too.
You. It's nice to be here.
And I want to thank you for coming today, because we're going to talk a lot about, well, we're going to talk about Garland Summer Musicals as a wrap-up to begin the show with today, and everything that happened this summer. It's just been an amazing summer with ticket sales.
We have had a phenomenal year this year with phenomenal shows.
Come on with the rain.
And the shows were Singing in the Rain, which broke all box office records. And then we went with the Dolly Parton Spectacular, 9 to 5, which we had a great time with, and the people came out. It was amazing. Last summer, our attendance was really down, and this summer, we broke all records. So I guess the economy has improved some, and I'm just real proud of the shows. I think the cast had a wonderful time, and the audiences did too, and hopefully they'll be coming back next year. I think we'll give them a sneak preview of what's going to happen. We're telling them we are going to be doing Peter Pan, and I know that's a
yes.
show that your mother has been promoting, and Gordon and Alice Stone too, who's one of our major donors for the Garland Summer Musicals. But I think one of the reasons we'll be able to do that was the success of this summer, because doing Peter Pan is going to require a lot more money to fly, and we'll bring in a flying company to do that. And this last year we just flew Greg Hullett, who was in 9 to 5. He flew with a garage door opener, supposedly, several
he
times
lifted.
In the show.
We'll actually see flying in Peter Pan, so we're taking it step by step, getting into the more advanced
exactly.
flying. Exactly.
And we told everyone this was our practice to do Peter Pan,
there
was flying
go.
Greg.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I am happy again. I'm laughing at clouds. Dark up above, the sun's in my heart, and I'm ready for love.
But we had an amazing summer, as we said, and I know we're showing clips right now that Dan has graciously come in and shot both of the shows this summer, so we can put some clips on the air and promote everything that happened for the 2013 Garland Summer Musicals. And then we'll be preparing for 2014, too. So I know that we're showing a lot of this right now as we're speaking, and we're going to segue here in just a moment now. We want to talk about the Modern Quilt exhibit, which will be coming up, and what are the dates on that, Kim?
It opens August 5th, which is a Monday, and it will run through the middle of September, and this is one of the first textile visual events that we've had here at the Granville Arts Center in our gallery space.
And we're excited about that. And of course, we brought this hanging system in a few mm-hmm. years ago, which has enabled us to do that. Otherwise, we would not have been able to have this show.
That's right. The hanging system makes all the difference. We put pockets on the backs of our quilts so that you can't tell anything's going on the front, run a PVC pipe through it, and we're able to hang the quilts nice and flat so that people can see how beautiful they are.
Now, the modern quilts, it's a whole different
It is. It's a different ball game altogether. I mean, it's still cutting up large pieces of fabric and putting them back, sewing them back together to make another large piece of fabric, but different aesthetic qualities in the modern quilting. Typically with modern quilts, you see asymmetry, whereas in traditional quilting, everything is very symmetrical, stars. You also see a lot of blank space in a quilt, and you can see that in this quilt.
This
is a prime example of a modern quilt. You can see asymmetry. You have a few of the flying geese. These are called flying geese here and over here, but not the same amount and not in equal ways. Then you also have all of this blank space, and that's called negative space, and that is a big feature in modern quilting. Also, in this smaller quilt here, you can see the use of solids. This is done entirely with solid fabrics, and that is a big trend in modern quilting. The binding is a pieced binding. It's not one solid piece of fabric, but it's made from all the fabrics inside of the quilt. Another feature that you find a lot in modern quilts,
let's
we'll go back
this one
to this one, the back. Backs used to be thought of as just one big piece of fabric, boring, forget about those. In a modern quilt, they're often pieced and sometimes leftovers from the front, sometimes new fabrics all together, but this is a wonderful example of a pieced back, which is just as beautiful as the front of the quilt.
It's just magnificent. How many quilts do you think will be in the exhibit?
We're hoping for a minimum of 20. It could be up to 30. With quilters, it's very interesting. Sometimes quilts take years to make, and when you give them a deadline like we have for this exhibit, all of a sudden they can magically get the quilts made, and but not until the last second, of course.
Now,
so we have several people frantically quilting right now, trying to get them done.
What age did you start quilting?
I started when I was 8 years old, and I went to my mother, who I had seen sew, but she did not quilt. She made clothes. And I said, I think I'm going to make a quilt. Can I use some of these scraps? And she said, sure, do you know what you're doing? And I said, oh, I'll figure it out. And I did. And I entered it at the State Fair of Texas, and I won first place.
Congratulations.
With my first quilt, and I have been quilting off and on ever since.
Well, I know your mother has done quilting for many years. That's Carla Pageau, and she started doing, and for me, I remember the 25th anniversary, this magnificent quilt using t-shirts of all the summer musical shows. And one side was all the shows I'd been in, and the other side was the other shows we had done. And it was just, I still have it. I mean, it is such a one, I treasure it so much. And I think she did another one as a fundraiser, too, as an item for a raffle, too.
She did. For the summer musicals.
It's amazing the things you can do with quilts.
We have a quilt in the show that the two of us worked on together, and I didn't have it here to show today, but it has over 7,000 pieces of fabric in it. So you can see why we worked on it together. Alone, I'm not sure either one of us ever would have finished it. So it's been really wonderful getting her involved in the quilting and being able to do that with her.
Well, it's exciting that you have brought this and that you're here today to talk about it, and this will be hanging here and people can come up and experience whenever when we have a show going on, of course, mm-hmm. and during our regular business hours, the lobby is open so they can drop in. And we do have some other things coming up that I want to mention. The whole season for Garland Civic Theater is beginning in August 22nd through September 14th. They usually start with an Agatha Christie, and that's what they're doing again, Go Back for Murder. And I think in August we're also going to have Kyle McLaren on, who is the artistic director, who will talk a little bit more in depth about these shows. In October, Daddy's Dying, Who's Got the Will. I've heard about this show. I have never seen it before. And then in November, All the King's Women. And this is something which is very interesting. It's all about Elvis's women. And All the King's Women sounds like it's going to be something that's a historical plot, but it's really not. Then in January, they're doing the blockbuster musical Chicago. In February, The Great Gatsby. And then April, it's a mystery whodunit. So that's the upcoming season for Garland Civic Theater. We want to make sure everyone knows about that. And also, there's some shows at the Plaza Theater that you had wanted to mention.
There are.
Country music?
The Garland Country Music Association does shows at the Plaza Theater throughout the year, and they do a wide variety of shows of local country artists. And coming up, they have Michael Hicks and Jenny Titlow, and that's on August 10th.
Yes.
At 7:30 at the Plaza, and you can go to the Garland Opry www.thebeatsbeat.com to get tickets or to get more information on that show. Someone else that's a regular at the Plaza Theater is David Allen, and he is an Elvis impersonator, speaking of Elvis. And,
August 24th,
and he does a wonderful job.
So those are some upcoming, and you can always check our website,
garlandarts.com, and we do have the excitement of getting a new website. It's still the same address, garlandarts.com, but it is going to look much more dramatic for the theater.
A landing page that should be coming up in August.
It should be, yes.
And Kim designed that. I mean, you did such an amazing job of all our promotions and all our communications, and you do the Arts in Action newsletter. And I wanted to bring one of those. I don't have one on the set with me now, but maybe we can show an insert of the newsletter, which you have been doing. It's been 2 years now that you've been
with us. It's been through a full redesign, and it has all the information, not only for the Granville Arts Center, but also the Plaza Theater. And if you'd like to get on that list, go to our website and you can find out exactly how to get on that mailing list.
You can receive a copy in the mail, or you can also see it online too.
That's right.
At our own website. So those are some of the things. And I know you're also on the board of the Downtown Business Group. And we have a few minutes left. Let's talk about some of the activities they have coming up.
The Garland Downtown Business Association is a wonderful group made up of people who care about downtown Garland and business owners in downtown Garland. And their big activity they have coming up is Fall for Garland, which is October 5th. It's a Saturday, and it's a day-long festival where there will be different events. They're going to have a ton of entertainment, wonderful entertainment, both local and national, that they're lining up right now. We're going to actually have two stages this year instead of one, so even more entertainment than before. And then, of course, all the booths and vendors, and that's going to be a wonderful event.
And you have one more thing you're involved in. Kim, I don't know when you sleep.
But I might not.
Between doing newsletters and everything else. But the movies, the series at the Plaza Theater.
That's right.
You started that a couple of years ago, and we have had a really great turnout the last few movies.
It started slowly, and it's building, as do most programs. Word of mouth takes a little while to get out there, but it's been wonderful to be building a program that does so much for the citizens of Garland. It's a free movie that you can come to, but then it also does a lot for the downtown businesses, because if people are going to go to the movie, then they're going to go get ice cream before or after, or go to the generator for coffee, or go out to dinner. We have so many wonderful restaurants in downtown, and the movies have just been wonderful. We just finished
Somewhere in Time,
which is your favorite movie
Absolutely.
Of all time.
And of course, Gone with the Wind, when we had that, and we had the costumes, the people were there so you could take pictures in costumes.
That's right.
It's been some fun events. Are there any exciting movies coming up?
Coming up, actually, during the Fall for Garland Festival on October 5th, we're going to be showing free classic cartoons and also episodes of Our Gang. So that will be wonderful.
Will be
and then
fun.
That evening, once the festival is over, we're going to do a silent movie festival with real piano players. They're playing along with the silent films. So that'll be a first for us, and it should be really amazing. And then, of course, we're going to repeat our biggest success from last year, which was White Christmas.
Yes.
And we'll be doing that right before the holidays.
I think that just about filled the house
with White Christmas. It did. 340 out of 350 people, so I'll take that.
Absolutely. And one other thing I want to reiterate, we have plenty of parking for everyone here at the Art Center. I realize that there's construction going on. The City Hall lot has been closed, but that's the only lot that's been closed. And we've opened up the parking garage, which is right across the street, the 5th Street parking garage is there with lots of signage. And all the parking at the Art Center is available at night and on weekends. And so far, we have not had any problems. I mean, we had 600 and 700 people here for the shows with Garland Summer Musicals this summer, along with weddings going on at the atrium. And this is a very active place downtown Garland, and we appreciate everyone coming down and experiencing what's going on. And I know with the downtown businesses, the restaurants, and like you said, they're very active, and there's been some changes. There's going to be with the Pocket Sandwich is now going to be serving alcohol, I believe.
That's right.
And then the
we
generator
might have our
is
own
changing.
Little pub.
Right, we have a pub. And I think with all the additions, all the apartments that are getting ready to be built mm-hmm. here. We're going to have a whole really active downtown, even more so, with people really living here. And, of course, the apartments that are across the street have been full. That's why they're building more apartments.
That's right.
It's going to have a whole new look in downtown Garland, that's for sure. Well, Kim, is there anything else you'd like to say before we leave? One more comment about the quilt show. Remind them of the dates.
The dates for the quilt show are August 5th through September 15th. And if you would like to see what a 7,000-piece quilt looks like, I truly encourage you to come down and check it out. There are some beautiful quilts that are going to be in there.
Well, thank you for joining us
today. Of course. Thank you for having me.
We look forward to seeing everyone again on Arts in Action.